Ben, Sam, and Ken are on separate journeys to defeat the menacing vile dragon. But let's just say luck isn't on their side. If only there was a way for them to find each other and band together. Well, that's why there's Band. It's a mobile app that allows people to come together using common interests. With Band, you can find fellow gamers, chat, schedule gaming sessions, and conduct polls. Stage epic battles with friends while sharing videos and photos along the way. So try Band today. Band. Be together.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the ULOL Campus Series 2017 presented by the Collegiate Star League. The best of the best in the nation are going to go head-to-head to win thousands of dollars in scholarship prizing. Tonight, it's a SoCal battle as Cal State Fullerton takes on UC Riverside. I'm Joshua Piscatore-Lee here alongside Bill Jump Carter, and I am particularly excited for this matchup. Bill, I'm not sure if you knew that.
I don't know about you, but there might be some caster bias for the first time in our casting career. As you, if I'm not mistaken, once attended Cal State Fullerton?
I did go to Cal State Fullerton, Titan, till the day I die. And I also actually coached the ULOL team last year, and then they got rid of me because apparently top three is not good. I'm just kidding. I just left the school. I coached the team last year. I went to Cal State Fullerton. That's where I got mostly invested into League of Legends. So to see my boys come back on the ULOL stream, very, very exciting.
Oh, without a doubt. Now, this is a much different Cal State Fullerton team than you did have in the previous year. The only remaining member on the roster is AD Chaos there, AD Carry, from the previous year. And while they are sitting up at 1-0, they do have quite a difficult opponent coming up this week with UC Riverside.
Yeah, UC Riverside. It seems like the SoCal region really tends to breed and put out the best of the esports world, whether it's collegiate, in the pro scene. Every single school that you generally encounter on the West Coast, and especially in Southern California, a lot of strength coming out of the region. This was one of the power regions ever since Collegiate League of Legends became a thing. For example, last year's champion and the year before, UBC came out of the Western region. Technically, they're Canada, but we, you know, especially nowadays, we're taking a lot of credit for what they're doing as well. So the West, very stacked region, puts out a lot of great competition. So tonight should be no exception as these two schools, nothing to shake your nose at.
No, without a doubt. And you also have to take a look at what UC Riverside actually has coming into this match. They lost week one against Advanced Technology, which actually came in as an underdog, believe it or not. And so while that team is sitting at the end of week two, 2-0, UC Riverside is going to have some ground to make up. And if they're able to take this game and tie up CSU, Cal State Fullerton very quickly, that could definitely make it for a much closer series as we see coming on throughout the rest of the year.
Yeah, especially considering that we're playing on the new patch that just dropped. There's a few changes that were implemented. Nothing too crazy in terms of the meta going in one direction or another. We're still going to see that holy trinity of, you know, LeBlanc, Rengar, Camille probably banned out or prioritized by both sides. Remember, for those of you who spend most of your time watching pro play, the 10-ban system is not yet in play in CSL, just like it isn't in play whenever you play solo queue. So we're still going to see 3 bans from each side. Actually makes for a very different environment, because I feel like, especially in years past, whenever we've casted Collegiate, the Collegiate group tends to take its, you know, its strategy, tends to take, you know, cues on the meta from the pro scene. But considering that pick ban plays out so differently in 3 bans versus, you know, each team getting 5 bans, I have no idea what we're going to see tonight.
No, and I think that kind of adds to it. You also have to remember we're on patch 7.2. We had a couple tweaks, a couple changes. I know the big Lulu fan that you are, seeing those couple buffs kind of, you know, excites the inner support in you. But seeing these different champions rise and fall throughout the meta obviously is kind of one of the most exciting things about League of Legends in and of itself. But more importantly, with the current state of the meta and with the current state of variety that teams have, certainly makes things that much more entertaining as a viewer.
Yeah, and entertainment has started as we're getting into the first pick ban phase. This is a best of three, so 2 games you win, you will move ahead. You'll advance your record or improve your record.
It does look like we're having a couple of technical difficulties. There he is. You went a little robot on me for a second. We're fine now. It's good. It's you went a little robot. I guess it was the Cal State. They're trying to mess with you. They don't want you sharing their secrets over on the UCR side. But we do have the Katarina, the Zyra, the LeBlanc, and the Malzahar banned away. We've seen the rise of the Malzahar support coming across the board, especially being very prevalent over in the LCK. Now, Katarina did get some cooldown reductions on her Shunpo. However, it is still very surprising that they're seeing her banned away so quickly.
I got robot voice too, so I barely heard what you said. What's going on with Discord? Come on, guys!
We gotta love it. We gotta love it. We gotta hate it indeed.
Okay, the chat's making sure to keep us honest right now. A lot of thanks a lot, guys. Really supportive of it. Malzahar, super, super important in the support role nowadays, being taken away by UCR on the second rotation. Final land coming out from Fulton. Gonna be that Hecker in Milo Pony. Not gonna see play in this game of the best of three.
No, without a doubt. We are going to do a quick little recheck real quick on our communication to try to get that thing fixed up. And it should be a lot better now. Can you hear us? Are we here? Are we alive?
Okay. I think we're good. Can you hear me?
We can. We're here. It's alive. Sorry, so sorry about that, guys. But we are right back into it. We're going to try to, you know, continue where we left off and kind of work through things from here. You did have an Ashe being first picked up. Excuse me. On the blue side, that first setup, I'm assuming that's going over into AD Chaos's hands. And then we still have the timer for the first 2 picks for the red side.
Okay, this is something that we've seen before last year in the Fullerton team. AD Chaos, or, you know, Daniel, because I've never called him AD Chaos before. This is really, really weird. He's very comfortable in a variety of champions, but I feel like he's most comfortable when it comes to playing utility or more of the support type AD carries, where he can play safe, make plays without, you know, going full tilt wild turtle into the back line. Ashe, very strong in the meta nowadays, not surprising to see that picked up. But that 1-2 rotation coming out from the red side, we know a lot of teams like playing red side nowadays due to the incredible variety of champions that can be played. Syndra, still up on the table. We have some other high priority champions like Karma available, but it's actually going to be a first rotation Zac pickup, very early to pick up that champion. Not really contested, I would say.
Not necessarily contested at all. You've got a lot of other high priority, high damage junglers. You see the Triforce junglers definitely being a powerful pick in the Collegiate scene because of the early, very powerful spikes at those hits. But for me, you see Jae Young here wanting to prioritize that gank ability as well as that distance that Zac can create. When you look at a lane that's oppressive as something like a Karma, not only does she have the poke, but she also has the sticking with the tether, if she's able to land that, could prove for some very deadly ganks into the bot side. And as we know, looking back at last year with Cal State Fullerton, a lot of teams prioritized making sure that AD Chaos stayed down, because when he's riding high, the team is riding high with him.
And we know Poppy, somebody else who can ride high and just stay there the entire time. Poppy picked up in the top lane. I guess we technically could see it support, but that's not, I haven't really seen that in like When's the last time we saw Poppy support? Like
Poppy
6 months
been,
a year?
Oh, it's so wild. The poke heavy supports are just way too strong.
Yeah, you don't really want to draft a Poppy into a Karma. So most likely going top lane. Axel going to pick up the Lee Sin in the jungle. And this is really interesting because the very first, I believe, League of Legends tournament I ever played, casual or not, I actually played with Axel. It was a Cal State Fullerton in-house event. We joked around calling him a Lee Sin one trick because Lee Sin was always banned out. Axel has played a lot of Lee Sin in solo queue. We know that Lee Sin is incredibly strong in the current meta for his playmaking ability in addition to his ability to stay healthy in the early game. And that gank pressure, level 3, is incredibly strong. So look to Axel to maybe carry this game. We'll have to see exactly how Fullerton utilizes that jungle pressure. But Gangplank and Jhin being hovered on the other side.
The Jhin strength that you have had just in pure scalability definitely is adding into things. The Triforce buffs that I was, or the Triforce, I guess, prioritization that I was talking about earlier definitely looks like that's going to be the ganks here with the Gangplank. Now, there is the opportunity for them to be able to send that in the mid lane with Pingme or to go up to the top lane with Saucy Cells. That is yet to be seen. However, with somebody like the Poppy looking up into the top lane, I wouldn't be surprised if they just send the Gangplank to the top, make that a farm lane, and try to create some global pressure as he tries to scale himself up accordingly.
Especially later on in the game. They have such great late, like long-range initiation with their fights because you have the global coming out from Gangplank, Jhin just shoots you from 4,000 miles away, and Zac can come flying in from like 15, 1600 range. So when you have a Karma on top of that to speed up your entire team to get into the fight, I feel like Cal State Fullerton are going to have to stay on their toes, make sure their vision game is on point, they don't get flanked, make sure that Fog of War is nicely accounted for, because any moment where Cal State Fullerton kind of oversteps, UCR has that ability to kind of just jump right on them. But it looks like Orianna and Nami going to be the last two picks coming in for Fullerton. Orianna, that farm mid laner, Nami, very, very strong in lane, probably one of the best level 1 supports out there. That team comp, round it out.
The team comp is just a pride and joy of what we're used to seeing from Cal State Fullerton. It's the ability to team fight. It's the ability to act as a unit and use that power and that synergy with your team to propel you towards victory. You have the Ashe with the utility, which is something that we've seen AD Chaos play from time between the Ashe and the Sivir and the like. He has that ability. You've got the Nami to protect him as well, and then the AoE that all of these members provide. And it's really going to be up to that positioning, like what you said, coming out of AD Chaos and even Yuya for some of the reasons because of getting that prioritization in those team fights. Now you flip around and look at what we have to round everything out. You have pure team fight on one side, and then you have pure aggression coming out here for UCR.
UCR drafting that Ahri in the last rotation. We know Ahri very good at setting up ganks, and considering that you have a Zac who has your back the entire time, level 3 is going to be incredibly scary for Sakaki Yuya in the mid lane. And that's actually we were talking a little bit about how AD Chaos is the only returning member for the Fullerton roster. Technically, Sakaki Yuya is a returning member. He was our sub/manager last year, Jordan Smart. So this is his first time really playing on the team. It's going to be interesting to see how he steps into that role. I know he's kind of in love with Diana and Lucian. Seeing him on a much different style of champion, Orianna compared to Lucian and Diana, I'd say pretty different, right?
No, it just
a little bit. A little bit, but decent team fighting, very strong scaling comp coming out of Fullerton. But then again, UCR has that kind of team comp where if they get ahead, they're so hard to stop.
I agree. And the one thing that we're going to have to look for is the TP pressure. Looking back at week one, all across the board, there was a very severe lack of teleport presence from a lot of these top laners. Granted, last week, a lot of the featured matches weren't the highest echelon of League of Legends play. However, at the same time, the ability to affect the map globally certainly separates the good teams from the great. It's something that I know both of these teams tried to prioritize in week one. The real question on their success is going to be how well they utilize that here in game two.
All right, well, game one, technically.
Week two.
Week two, there we go. Week two, game one about to start. We're getting into our spectator delay. We're going to see if UCR can use that aggressive early game team composition to get snowballing and get themselves an early victory. Or maybe Fullerton can get to that point where they start scaling up. Poppy becomes unkillable. Orianna starts two-shotting everybody. Have to see how the game goes. Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching the ULOL Campus Series 2017 presented by the Collegiate Star League in partnership with Band Gaming, Twitch,
and Asus. For those of you wondering, what is Band Gaming? Well, Band is a social app and the primary social app of the CSL, with many features such as creating groups, boards, calendar functions, polls, chat, and as of recent call functionality, Band is the premier social experience for you and your fellow gamers alike. We're going to get into a quick break, but before we do, why don't we hear from our sponsors real quick.
Only $14.99.
Don't miss the call. Download Band. Communication made easy.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the ULOL Campus Series 2017. Tonight's match between Cal State Fullerton and UC Riverside. Cal State Fullerton rocking the blue with Sign My Waffle in the top lane, Axel in the jungle, Sakaki Yuya in mid lane, AD Chaos in bot, and S Huang on supports.
And for the side of UC Riverside, it's going to be Saucy Cells in the top lane, Jay Young in the jungle, Ping Me in the mid lane, Akuya Wind at AD Carry with Sora Sky at support. As we see right off the bat, a little bit of some level one knowledge acquisition as they have stormed in, acquired a little bit of Ward Vision. Ping's going down, but as we know, there is still a lot of a lack of level one aggression, as getting that early jungle experience super important for both of these teams.
All right, so it looks like Axel not going to get spotted out on Fullerton's side by that enemy invade. He got a little bit of a chance to go in and drop a ward by the Raptors, so I believe he does see Pingmi Iint over there on that side. Actually, Pingmi hiding in that bush, so not exactly going to spot that Ahri out just yet. Axel going to move down to the bot side, so Riverside is going to know exactly where the enemy jungler is starting. We talked a lot about how early aggression is probably going to be a key in who ends up winning this game. Let's see if this extra information helps Riverside.
Yeah, and something that we're going to have to look for is how this early Zac pick is going to pay off. Granted, you do have a Lee Sin who is a, you know, just as aggressive jungler as that Zac in the early setup. However, the Zac is much more capable at the counter ganks and using that counter aggression to really help out his lanes. And so that's going to be extremely key as we see a lot of trades back and forth. Pingmi doing a lot of work and trying to get as much poke down on Sakaki as usual.
Yeah, I know we're gonna keep a close eye on the mid lane, especially because these junglers have very, very hard spikes when it comes to level 3. Get an Ahri or an Orianna snowballing, very good news for that team in particular. But we see, if we're looking all across the map, any single one of these lanes has the potential to snowball and completely take over the game. How many times have we seen a Poppy get a level experience in gold lead and just completely wreck everybody because she's like near unkillable? How many times have we seen Jhin one shot a squishy on the other team? Every single lane has carry potential, so I'm going to be curious to see exactly who gets that carry love.
And you also have to consider what happens if the Poppy is able to use that teleport presence. Yes, going against the Gangplank, naturally, you're going to have a sense of counteractivity because of the global ultimate that the Gangplank provides. However, Sign My Waffle has a very good situation that she's in where there really isn't any card of guaranteed hard CC coming out of the enemy bot lane. You've got a conditional CC in both Sora as well as Akuyo. And so if she's able to get a successful teleport down to the bot lane and get that position correctly, could mean disaster for UCR once the lane starts rolling.
Yeah, have to keep a close eye on Poppy, see exactly where she goes. It looks like Axel on Fullerton's side is actually looking for the enemy jungler on his side. Gonna drop a ward on the red buff, get out, start clearing the rest of his camps. Fullerton operating with a little bit more knowledge than they were a minute ago. But so far, relatively peaceful across the rift. All these students being good sports with each other.
Trying to keep things a little simple, you do see a little form of aggression coming off AD Chaos, something that he's definitely accustomed to seeing and accustomed to trying out on a day-to-day basis. Both junglers now on opposite sides of the map, so there isn't going to be any chance for counter ganks. However, SimyWaffle has done a fantastic job at warding up on that top side of the map, so he's going to have complete vision of if Jae Young wants to go and try to party in the top lane.
They may not have the best collegiate coach NA anymore, but you guys are doing me proud. I'm going to be super biased throughout this entire thing. I'm just warning everybody.
Even if
Fullerton gives up first blood, I'm going to say it's calculated. If we get wiped at Baron and throw hashtag Dignitas, I'm going to say it's, you know, just psychological warfare. My eyes, this team can do no wrong. Right, Jump?
I'm going to plead the fifth on that one and say, okay, buddy, as we see another form of a little aggression coming out of Sign My Waffle. And I really look to see this Poppy pick essentially making or breaking a lot of whether or not Fullerton is able to find success in the teamfight phase. As we see now, Axel trying to get something through. Doesn't look like anything's going to land, though.
Yeah, bot lane duo of Riverside a little bit too far back in their lane for Axel to really do anything. The wise, great player he is, though, just going to back out. What an excellent decision right there. Right, Jump?
Oh, it's going to be a long best of three, my friend.
It's going to be a great best of three, unless Fullerton loses, in which case I will tilt off the face of this planet, I swear.
Now,
so far, though, nothing too crazy.
No, not at all. And believe it or not, considering we assumed a lot of aggression in the jungle, Jae Young has actually prioritized a lot of that early farm. As I do say that, they did meet each other around the bottom tri-bush, but you have a 9 CS advantage in the jungle right now. Granted, a lot of that is sort of, I guess, disoriented and discombobulated considering the amount of minion CS that you get from the Raptors. However, being able to get that early experience and hit that level 6 and have that extra form of crowd control available could be beneficial for the UCR squad if that's what they so choose.
Yeah, and talking about level 6, a lot of these lanes are getting close to that level 6 mark. The global ult's coming out of Saucy. We're talking about how that has
huge implications further in the game. Jaehyung, however, looking to visit Sakaki in the mid lane. Chilling Smite is down. Sakaki going pretty low. The Thunderlords has been procced, and Ping Me actually taking down the first blood of the game. Sakaki, the master he is, getting the return kill. The first blood to Riverside.
It was a one for one. Both summoners were flashed from the mid laners. However, Ping Me mistimed that charm a little bit, predicted the flash, but was just enough pixels off. Sakaki as well, able to use that command protect, traded off. So all in all, it was a successful attempt by UCR, but Sakaki and the rest of the Cal State Fullerton team is able to strike back.
One benefit that UCR does have is the fact that Jaehyung did manage to get that assist. We're talking about how he was a little bit of golden farm ahead in the early game, now just a little bit further ahead. Taking a look at the gold count, it seems like Jaehyung is about 300 gold ahead of Axel in the jungle. Not something super, you know, noteworthy in the early game, especially in the first 6.5 minutes, but that's something that, you know, that 300 can turn into 1,000, 2,000 very, very quickly. Especially putting that gold on Ahri, very good at roaming and applying that pressure to other lanes. Fullerton has to be careful.
Yeah, and you can see Ping Me, though, definitely respecting the power of this Orianna in the mid lane. Did decide and go back to get that Fiendish Codex, but also picked up a Null Magic Mantle as well to help stop and deny a little bit of that as the Ghost gets popped, and here comes Axel.
Axel, gonna land the Resonating Strike. Sakaki, oh boy, all right. Once your jungler says back off, you gotta back off, buddy. No taking tower shots to the face.
Did decide to back up, but you didn't have level 6 as well from Axel. There could have been an opportunity to get a flash kick on, but without the Dragon's Rage there, they weren't able to do much. That's also the Ghost popped now as well. So both summoner spells down in the mid lane, going to give an opportunity for this level 6, and just as we say so.
No flash on the Orianna. He's gonna have to go for the trade, but I don't think it's gonna happen. Shockwave gonna be burned, but Ping Me gonna pick up the second kill for Riverside. This Ahri getting very scary.
Getting very scary indeed. That second kill is huge because now that's going to be able to create that much more an advantage. You got the trade off in the first kill that you had, and you had Sakaki that was even. But now with this gold that's extra, I would not be surprised if you see a go back, and the second that Ignite and Ultimate is back available, a roam down to that bottom side of the map.
It's getting tricky for that mid lane. Ahri picking up the blue buff. In addition to Sakaki dropping for the second time this game. Taking a look across the rest of the map, though, CS leads pretty darn even. It looks like the bot lane actually looking to commit. AD Chaos gets locked down. Daniel can't take any more shots, otherwise he's gonna fall. The Deadly Flourish, one shot onto Sora. They're both getting very low. This could be a close one jump. Swang taking frontline duty as the Nami, but no Sushi for Riverside today as Nami gets out alive. Both AD carries surviving the fight.
Very smart decision there for AD Chaos to remain patient, not waste his heal too early, and that was able to force the double summoner spells coming out of Sora. You still have the advantage with the heal up on Akuyo's side, as well as that flash. You could see Axel lurking around trying to see if he could get a little cheeky playoff, but still going to be a reset, still going to be an even setup there in the bot lane.
And we see how this increased pressure that Jaehyung has been putting on, especially with those double mid lane ganks. Axel's been kind of running around the map trying to figure out where he has to go next. We see in the CS count, he's down 6 CS, down 2 assists. That gold lead in the jungle is growing more and more. And we're taking a look at team gold. UCR finally pulling ahead with the first significant gold lead that we've seen in this game, with 1,000 gold up over Fullerton.
1,000 gold doesn't seem like a lot on paper, but considering you have champions that spike so hard once they get that first item, you look at Jhin, Ahri, and Gangplank being pure examples of that. That 1,000 gold is going to be a huge window of opportunity for them to sincerely take advantage. You still don't have any teleports down to the bot lane, both of them on cooldown, using them to actually get back to lane and stay relevant themselves. But once that first item gets completed onto Saucy, I wouldn't be surprised if he tried to make something happen.
See that Sheen getting very close to that Phage as well. Waffle with the first buy coming in the form of the Bomby Cinder. Gonna push ahead, gonna make pushing that lane a little bit easier. Kyowin, Swang hiding around in that River Brush alongside Axel. They have a control ward in there, so they know that Riverside can't exactly see them.
Uh-oh.
The arrow comes in, here they come on to win. The flash kick in the bubble to suspend him in the place, and that's one Jhin getting mixed with Tonic as AD Chaos takes him down.
That's a perfect setup there by Axel. You're gonna have a nice reverse gank here.
Sakaki again in the mid lane getting picked on over and over again.
Pingmi gonna jump in to get the finishing touch on him. Sakaki Yuya not having a fun game. That is that Orianna's third death of the match.
So the eternal game of League of Legends chess. You're going to take one of ours. We're going to take one of yours. AD Chaos starts to get rolling. He gets the advantage. But this Ahri, as we said, is coming back stronger than ever. And with the lack of mobility on someone like an Ashe, if you don't have the support from the rest of your team, this could potentially be a difficult situation if Pingmi is able to continually scale up and to continually dominate the way he has thus far.
Especially considering later and later on into the game, Ahri's CDR just kind of gets to a point where she's always spirit rushing. Scariest thing as an AD carry, when you're just sitting backline, Ahri just dashes forward three times, hits you in the face with a charm. I'll tell you, man, that's one foxy lady I don't want to go out with.
It is not indeed. You don't feel like going out on a date. No buying drinks, no nothing, because it's just going to be running around circles. And I'm sorry, but I'm just not quite enough in shape for that.
I'm not playing games, man. That those days are behind me. That's why I'm not at Fullerton anymore. That college play, nah. Ain't about that life.
Not at all. As we do see UCR now trying to prioritize a little bit of that bottom vision. You can see the conceal, excuse me, you can see the revealing ward in the bot side. Eswang is going to end up clearing both of those off. However, with that prioritization at the moment, and you see Sora Sky coming back to lane, I wouldn't be surprised if you do see a play around that mountain drink fairly soon.
And we see Axel trying to get vision down in the enemy jungle. Maybe trying to make a play towards the Riverside bot lane as well. But it looks like Jhin and Karma going to respect that jungle pressure. Eswang going to take this opportunity to move in, get rid of that ward. Getting that vision priority for Fullerton. We saw that last play go in favor of Fullerton in the bot lane. But like you said, every time some duo lane fight, seems like there's another fight going down on the opposite side of the map. 13 minutes into the game, nothing too crazy. Riverside slowly pulling ahead more and more in gold at this point, 1.7 ahead.
Yeah, you do also see that Saucy Sales did complete that Trinity Force. The Sunfire Cape also being completed on a Simite Waffle, and their teleports are available. Now, with the Mountain Drake being as powerful as it is in the turret-taking world, having these early spikes and having these, these spikes is the easiest words. The words fail me sometimes. you have that completed now onto UC Riverside. We knew that was going to be a strategy for them coming into this. And so, again, if you can have the teleports down now that those items are completed, I wouldn't be surprised if that Mountain Drake is short to follow. And just like that on cue, Pingmi starts to roam around, gets the plant to throw themselves over.
That's like a starting pistol for, hey, we're starting Dragon. Not the most subtle way to start Dragon. But it doesn't look like they actually want to do it. Pingmi looked like they wanted to. Gonna rotate back to the mid lane, try to get that shoving in. Sakaki Yuya, for the fourth time this game, gonna get jumped on by the Zac. But AD Chaos here for the backup. Fullerton here in forces. Jaehyung, the passive, gonna get popped. He's trying to find an entrance into this fight, but I don't think the fourth that you want. Axel finally mopping up the King Jello. Fullerton getting up the kill count at 3 apiece. Jungler down, Dragon up. What does this mean next?
It is going to mean an immediate return right back to lane, actually, as Akuyo did have that lane pushed up. You had a wave and a half coming right in onto the bot side, so they don't want to risk losing that turret. They don't want to risk giving up that first turret blood over to UCR, and so it's going to be a nice little help, a nice piece of support, but an immediate return right back to the bot lane.
Absolutely, they're going to get caught out, trying to clear that control. We're going to get tethered down. He misses the subtle crab, managed to safeguard away. Ahri gonna flash forward, Pingmi laying down the ignite, and that is that Ahri's fourth kill of the game. Every single kill that UCR has is on that Ahri. Sakaki Yuya having a terrible game in the mid lane, gonna get shot out again. Three members of UCR taking credit for that. Actually, doesn't look like one of them actually got in on that. Jhin and Karma taking down the Ahri.
The bad goes to worst as you have this Ahri consistently snowballing herself further and further ahead. Not only do you get the kill up onto Axel as well, but Akuyo throwing the best Korean sniper impression as a fantastic kill onto Sakaki. Sakaki is struggling. Yes, she's only down about 20 CS, even considering the immense amount of power that Pingmi has had, but 1-4 is not a stat line to be proud of. It's going to take a lot of power, and more importantly, a lot of a reset, rather, coming out of the Cal State Fullerton team, because they're down now just over 4,000 gold. You did have the first turret going down in the mid lane, and now you have the roam on at the top. Flash is available on the sign my waffle, but it's going to be a three-man roam here to the top side.
No keeper's verdict up either. Waffle, gonna want to get out of here unless he wants to get 3v1 bopped in the top lane. But it looks like, given that there's all that pressure from UCR topside, Fullerton instead gonna turn their attention towards the Drake. But Jay, I'm gonna say that's enough. I'm going in on this Poppy. It's a 2v1 so far. Let's see if Ari wants to jump in. There they go, and Waffle gonna get buttered up by the top tower. But it does look like Fullerton managed to respond with the first Drake of the game. Arrow gonna go wide, but it looks like UCR gonna look to commit to take this tower, but who's gonna take the first tower?
The first tower did go down into the mid lane. You're having a rebuttal coming from Cal State Fullerton, which is fantastic. But the most difficult part about that entire gank for Cal State Fullerton is the fact that they were able to successfully give that kill over onto Saucy Cells. Yes, you did have the Q from Ari out and launched, but still, being able to get that kill into another member instead of funneling all of that gold in one direction, certainly going to be helpful for UCR moving forward.
UCR looking across the items right now. Seeing a type of shoe on Jhin that I don't typically see him rocking, but I respect his sneaker game. Lucidity boots on Jhin. Typically we see swiftness. Why do you think this is?
The Lucidity boots is a line of play that you've actually seen a couple Jhins go for to make sure that they can have that prioritization for their W. Something that you lack in this team composition is consistent forms of crowd control. You have very high cooldowns and only limited amounts of CC, most of it being single target outside of Jae Young and that Zac. And so prioritizing those CDR boots early, gonna reduce the cooldown down on the Jhin W just enough that will help out provide a little bit more consistency on that crowd control from the backline.
I guess also if you think about it, we have a lot of damage coming out of the top lane and the mid lane, so you're not as reliant on Jhin to have those huge one-shot crits. Play more of that utility AD carry role as we've seen so prevalent in both the professional and the collegiate meta. So for those of you wondering why in chat, why Jhin has Lucidity boots, that's one way of looking at it. Helping out the team, because at the end of the day, it's your team that gets the W. It's not just you. Who cares if you carry this game if your team loses? You know what I mean? Uh-oh. Eswang in trouble here. Ari has an appetite for fish, and it looks like that Fox gonna chew up that mermaid. Oh no! Eswang actually makes it out alive. But here's that global pressure coming from Saucy that we spent so much time talking about.
Yeah, you knew if you were UCR that it's going to be very difficult to be able to push on to Sign My Waffle. He's got the crowd clear with not only the skills from Poppy as the kit itself, but the Sunfire cape as well. So they sent Saucy Cells down to the bot lane, and that pure damage that you have coming out of the two item gangplank only at 18 and a half minutes wasn't enough for AD Chaos to handle, only just now completing that first item. And if you want to talk about being at a deficit, Cal State Fullerton definitely in that case right now.
I mean, we talked about how it was so crucial for Fullerton to make sure that UCR doesn't get snowballing. But looking all across the board, 2-0-1 on the gangplank, 4-1-1 on the Ahri. This Zac doesn't care at all because he's so damn tanky. Axel getting exhausted, looking for a way out of this fight. But now Fullerton looking for the turn. This Zac getting pretty darn low. Sign My Waffle flashes up, not wanting to take it around the wall. UCR, however, the fight is split across two different separate places of the jungle. Axel, the first one to fall on Fullerton's side. Now it's a 4v5. Eswang going pretty darn low. Pinky looking for the dive in. Gonna get exhausted, forcing the Ahri up. AD Chaos gets tagged, and then he gets blown up by the Jhin. Yukaki Kuya giving up its fifth death, manages to flash out just in time. Deadly skirmish in the jungle yields 2 kills to Riverside, maybe another tower.
It was the perfect back and forth teamfight play that UCR needed to prioritize coming into this. They know that if it's a full 5v5 and if they sit and they wait, it's going to be a Cal State Fullerton victory. Yes, they're down 6,500 gold, but there's so much AoE CC, so much teamfight power that they needed to play the patient game, and that's exactly what happened. They're able to pick up the kills where needed, secure themselves a bot lane turret inner. Now they're going to be able to go back and reap their rewards.
So, like I said before the game, I'm a huge UC Riverside fan. I had nothing but faith in Riverside since the beginning.
You bandwagoning fool!
This is looking pretty bad for my alma mater, not gonna lie, Bill.
It is, but you have to give a lot of credit where credit is due. The prioritization by UCR to get the lane ahead that would best help their team succeed did just that. Jae Young picked the Zac early. It was a little bit of a thinking face moment for the both of us on how or whether or not that was going to pay out. 0-1-6, honorable stat line, but what's more important is what he was able to do in catalyzing and helping grow the lead that Pingy had already established in the mid lane to something of a 5-1-2 Ahri that you see right now.
Something else to consider in this game is the fact that Orianne and Ahri, both two champions that are very, very good in the late game, but outside of the utility that comes out of their ults, I mean, they really need that three-item spike, as it looks like Saucy Cells only needs 2.5 to one-shot an AD carry. AD Chaos going down for the third time this game, only sitting on that Essence Reaver and Recurve Bow. Fullerton fiending for some items in gold right now.
Now, looking at what you see from the Fullerton squad, yes, they're down almost 10,000 gold at the 21.5 minute mark. They're going to have their fifth turret fall as well. And very, very soon, almost immediately, and then that sixth turret with three members coming in, Akuya Wind doing as strong as he has. And there's the difficulty is that even though you have a team composition that can wave clear fairly well, you're so far behind that you're not actually able to get anything through without dying. The one-shot potential of many of these players, Saucy Sales and Pingy, being the priority targets in that 3-0-1, 5-1-2 respectively, definitely something that's setting Cal State Fullerton off. And unless they're able to find a way to stop this just constant dissection that you see coming from UCR's side, might be an ugly rest of the game for them. Does look like we're having technical difficulties. We are 0-2 now with both Skype and the Discord. We're gonna try to get him back momentarily. But as we do see where things are standing right now, it is 10-3 in favor of UC Riverside. You've got the Water Drake against the Mountain Drake. Not anything too, I guess, insane when it comes down to, when it comes down to things in general, but it's the 12,000 gold that really makes things a little crazy.
Oh, sorry, I was gone. I was going shopping for some UCR goodies, like a sweater, a hat, a shirt.
Yeah. Represent your new swag at the next ULOL.
Anybody want to buy my Cal State Fullerton shirt in the chat? Oh boy, sign my waffle. Not gonna have a waffle left to sign if he gets taken out. Gonna run out though. Looks like Riverside slowly taking over the entire jungle of Cal State Fullerton. Just a Christmas tree chain of wards being left in that blue side, and it looks like they're gonna set up a little death bush here. The Hawkshot gonna scout it out though, but Vision Control going staunchly in favor of Riverside.
Dun, 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 dun. It's the ever hopeful music of Cal State Fullerton.
Okay, man, I've casted enough games to know that this is looking pretty bad for my boys.
It is. So
I can't
back
even sugarcoat it at this point. It's like, all right, it's looking. I mean, we can't get to super, super late game. That is the silver lining. But considering, look at this Baron. Look how fast it's going down. UCR, with that early aggression, gets snowballing to this point, absolutely melting the purple worm. Fullerton, no vision in this area, unable to actually get there. By the time they show up, it's like way too late. Here comes the engage. Sora Sky getting tagged up by the Enchanted Crystal Arrow, but the rest of Fullerton nowhere to be found. Waffle forced to flash out. The rest of the Fullerton boys on the run. Redemption comes down. Rose AD Chaos, Simai Waffle looking for a pick onto Saucy, and they do find one for their efforts. Rest of Fullerton, they know that the rest of the team can probably 4v5 them. But they're just going to take one and run.
Yeah, there's no reason for them to overcommit. There's no reason for them to just make anything worse than it already did. Yes, they lost one member, but you do still have the Baron on four other members of the UCR squad. With six turrets down to one, there's really not much that Cal State Fullerton is going to have to do. Going to be able to do, even.
Maybe able to get one tower here. Axel, look at how bad that Lee Sin gets chunked. Jay Young going in, looking for an assassination. Pingmi gonna find one onto Axel and onto Swang. Fullerton dropping three members, a triple kill for the Ahri. Akio Wind on that Jin, picking up Waffle in the top lane, and now it's just Sakaki Yuya alive and left to fend for his team's base. 14-4, the kill count in favor of Riverside, and right now their gold lead is looking really damn strong at 14,000.
14,000 gold in under 25.5 minutes in this game. Now, by and large, you can safely say that this game is quite almost over if you're Cal State Fullerton. However, to their advantage and to the hopeful alumni or semi-alumni, sorry, coming from you, there is the opportunity to come back because this is a best of three, mind you. So there is a lot of opportunity that they can create for game two. It's not that they had any sort of mechanical discrepancy or anything of the sort. It was the sheer fact that Ping Me and the entire rest of the UCR squad did things. Is now...
Big hit onto the Jin. Akio win. Not getting kicked out quite just yet. Oh, the Dragon's Rage isn't even up. That's why he wasn't being kicked back. Finally comes off cooldown, and Axel manages to finish him off. Thora Sky now getting jumped on with the rest of the team, but now it's Sign My Waffle. 3v1 in the top lane. This Poppy just trying to buy some time. Sakaki Yuya finally picking up a kill onto the opposite support. But Baron buffed wave in the top side. Gonna make sure UCR gets this inhibitor tower. Fortune trying to get back here. Looks like UCR not going to play greedy, just going to take the tower and run.
Now, generally, you would take a 2-for-1 any day of the week, but when you had a Baron-ridden wave and now an open inhibitor in the top side, definitely not spelling well for Cal State Fullerton. They've got the middle inhibitor down, so they're already having to worry about the supers there. Now they have to worry about the top lane being open with the strength of Saucy Cells, almost 40 CS up. Excuse me, almost 50 CS up, rather, on Sign My Waffle.
Ever math on stream.
It's just terrible. It's absolutely outrageous, the math skills that I have and the comparison of how much UCR is actively walking around the map and just out-macroing every turn that CS Fullerton is trying to make.
So a minute until the next Drake spawns. It's going to be a Mountain Drake, and considering how much map pressure, UCR, currently has, giving that up is going to be even more painful, going to enable them to push even quicker into the Fullerton base. Taking a look at the gold right now, 15,000 and change in favor of the Riverside squad. Items, they're flossing. Fullerton right now wearing 10-year-old shoes. Riverside rocking the Yeezys. It's kind of the situation we got right now. Still comebacks are possible. Orianna and Ash both have very, very strong late games. So all I'll say is when I was coaching the team last year, we have thrown bigger leads.
Oh, goodness.
I'm just saying we have thrown bigger leads. I'm back on the Fullerton bandwagon. I believe in the boys. Let's get this. 15 seconds. Get that second Mountain Drake.
It is an opportunity. However, you do have to look at the objective nature of this game in the sense that you have a very powerful Gangplank in the top lane, has teleport as well as that ultimate available, constantly pushing up. Baron buff is now expired. However, that does not take away from the strength. You can see the zoning ultimate coming out of Jin. That's going to be a Nami wave to help it up, but I don't think there's much else they can do.
Not having the wave takes away a little bit of their engage. So without the Baron buff, it's kind of hard to push this wave in. Poppy, not much you can do against the Gangplank. Saucy doing his best to try and take down that top lane inhibitor. Waffle doing a good job of keeping that pirate away. No inhibitor for you, Captain Jack Sparrow.
No inhibitor indeed. It's slowly but surely they're whittling it around something that Jin is so certainly good at, as well as the pressure that Saucy Cells is going. But that's going to be the turret coming down, and it's going to be an engage here by Jae Young.
This could be the last fight of game one. Jae Young going in deep, zoning away the back line. My inner Korean coming out. Apologies. Sign My Waffle still trying to keep this Saucy Gangplank player away. The Keeper's Verdict comes out, but I don't think it's going to be enough. The inhibitor does fall. Now that's two inhibs down for Fullerton. Sign My Waffle going pretty darn low. This is not the time you want to die. And immediately it's a 5v4. The rest of the members of Fullerton, they have to keep the hopes alive. Jae Young jumping onto Sakaki Yuya. The Orianna falls. Ping Me going to take this Q to jump in. Gets one. Looking for the second. Takes down the Nami as well. And it's, oh baby, a triple for Ping Me in the mid lane of UCR. Four members down for Fullerton means the Nexus Towers are fair game. The Nexus is wide open. And just like that, UCR take down the Fullerton Titans in 29 minutes and 40 seconds. 1-0 in the series.
Faster than it began, there was a snowball headed in the direction of UCR. And down the river we went, and down the river we flew, as Fullerton goes down to a beautiful effort, but more importantly, an even more precise game plan coming out of UC Riverside. They picked the Zac early. They knew that they had to provide pressure early and find a way to get a lane snowballing. The dice were rolled. It was Ping Me that got the call, and that definitely ended up working out in their favor, finishing 11-1-4, a much superior stat line than any of the other members of UC or Cal State Fullerton combined. And just like that, game one goes over to UCR.
All right, 1-0 in the series so far between Cal State Fullerton and UC Riverside. going to take a quick break to see exactly or to give these teams a little bit of a chance to rediscuss their strategy, maybe come up with a new game plan for game two. But don't go anywhere. We have lots more collegiate action coming up. You're watching the ULL Campus Series 2017 presented by Collegiate Star League. We're going to take a few minutes, but when we come back, it'll be game two between Riverside and Fullerton.
Ben, Sam, and Ken are on separate journeys to defeat the menacing Vile Dragon. But let's just say luck isn't on their side. If only there was a way for them to find each other and band together. Well, that's why there's Band. It's a mobile app that allows people to come together using common interests. With Band, you can find fellow gamers, chat, schedule gaming sessions, and conduct polls. Stage epic battles with friends while sharing videos and photos along the way. So try Band today. Band. Be together.